What's up, everybody? Retros Niggas here, back at y'all with a new video. In today's video, I'll be doing a Jordan 4 cleat swap with a Flight 89 donor. I'm doing this project for Red Bull. They requested me to do a live soul swap for them at the Sneakers Summit storefront, and they sent me a pair of Adidas Stan Smiths. These things right here are really, really dope. This is my first pair of Stan Smiths. As you can see, it has the Red Bull logo right here. I tried these on for the first time and I was blown away. I did not think that this shoe right here would be such a comfortable shoe. You know, you wouldn't think that. So yeah, enough with the talking and let's get into the first step. The first step I'll be doing is removing the cleats from the Jordan 4 uppers. But before I remove the cleats, I have to make sure to tape off the leather. I'm doing this just in case any of the acetone runs off onto the leather while I'm separating the cleat. Now that everything's taped off, we can begin removing the cleat. To remove it, we'll only need two things, a heat gun and acetone. The first step you want to do is apply a generous amount of heat to the edges, and once you've got that down, apply a little bit of acetone, and then you'll slowly start to see the cleat separating. If I say I got it, then you know I got it. Yeah, bands, 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 can't fit in my pocket. Yeah, take off with me now, take off on my rocket. Yes, yeah, smash everything in aces. Now we off the follies. Now we on our own, driving with suspension. Wars, 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 that's a repetition. Pippin' Johnny Gill, that's a new addition. So now removing on to the most difficult step of this soul swap, separating the uppers from the Flight 89 donor. The uppers are just very tough to remove, but we will still be using the same method I used to remove the cleats. So yeah, let's get into it.
Young rich niggas, you know, so we ain't really never had no old money. We got a whole lot of new money though. Raindrop, drop top, smoking on cooking the hot pot, fucking on your bitch, yeah, dot, dot, dot. Cooking the coke in the crock pot, we came from nothing to something, nigga.
So the factory adhesive on the uppers is very difficult to remove. Acetone and cotter rounds just isn't enough for this task, so what I'll have to use is a Dremel and a sanding stone. I'm just going to be lightly grazing the sanding stone over the leather to remove the factory adhesive. So now I'm going to be using the Dremel to shave off a new layer on the midsoles. I'm doing this to remove all the factory adhesive and to roughen the surface for a better bond when gluing. While separating the uppers, I damaged some of the paint on the midsoles. I'm just going to go ahead and give them a fresh new repaint. So the first step I'll have to do is strip the paint from the midsoles. What I'll be using is a midsole paint remover from God of Souls. All you have to do is apply it onto the midsoles, let it sit for a couple seconds, and then rub away using a Scotch-Brite pad. Since I'm working on two pairs of the same swap, I decided to paint one midsole black and the other white. At the end of this video, I'll be revealing what the shoes look like, and I want you guys to let me know down below in the comments which shoe you choose. Drop top foreign when I pull up in my hood, and I keep up making good just to roll me up a wood, yeah. When they play this, she know this her favorite song. To begin the gluing process, I'll start off by applying one light coat of glue onto the midsoles. The glue I'll be using is Barge Super Stick Cement, and I'll be letting the glue cure for 3 whole hours. Seven, that's done, I'll start applying my second coat onto the midsoles and my first coat onto the uppers. And before I clamp the shoes, I'll be letting the glue cure for 2 hours. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If you did enjoy this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Also follow me on my Instagram, Retro Snickers, and Snapchat as well, and Twitter, it's all the same at name.
Make sure to follow me as well at ShoeHype69 on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat is IsaiHZZ23.
So thank you for watching, and have a great day.